Castle in My Dream is the next track. Really soothing. Like I said, that gave me a beachy vibe. Like I was just vibing on the beach. I get it though, like castle, like sand castle, so you know that's why it's a beachy vibe. I'm gonna build my castle. So basically this castle that he's talking about building in this track is like his dream, like his new purpose. Like he's saying like he's got a new purpose and it's filling him up and he can go for this purpose, you know, whatever it is, and he doesn't care if he feels lonely, like he's over being lonely like he just was in these past few tracks. He's ready to build this thing, whatever he wants to, and he's saying as long as he has one person that he dreams of come into his life, then he'll be okay. So basically he has faith and hope that he's going to find somebody else now. It kind of gives me like the Notebook vibes, you know? Like he's building a house for her, basically. Like, I'm going to build this castle for my future queen.
He's really just saying, like, I'm going to build a legacy or, like, I'm going to have big aspirations and really go for it.
Yeah.
And then one day I'll be able to have my queen share this with me.
Also, I think these lyrics in this song are a direct reference to the song Just the Two of Us by Bill Withers and Grover Washington Jr. Just the two of us.
I love how he ends it with, I'm leaving, going to my dreams.
So instead of just trying to find a girl, he's going to build his legacy.
His castle first.
Yeah.
And then his queen will come, you know. As long as his queen comes, at some point, he'll be okay. The next track is called A Day. What's that? A day, 날 잊어 물어가네.
Whoa. 우린 솔직해져야 해. 내일이 없기 때문에
Auto-tune. Oh. Ooh. Yeah. Some English. Sense. Oh. Oh.
Wow.
It's very cool, the day.
Yeah.
It was a really unique use of the auto-tune, the way it sounded there. So it's like, he's back to where he just was. Like, he's still in love with her. Like, he's still thinking about this person.
Like, he's going through his emotions of feeling right. like, oh, no, I'm good. I can just, you know, work on myself. And
right.
You know, now he's back to thinking, like, ah. Oh.
You know, it's getting dark. So maybe this is, like, towards the nighttime, you know? Like, mm-hmm. this is, like, a nighttime song. So he said to her, when I said I had nothing to regret when my life was over, I was actually pretending to be good. So he told her he has nothing to regret.
So he wasn't being honest with his right. feelings at first. Right.
Like he was saying, you know, he held back his tears at some point. You know, why did he do that?
But almost dying made him realize that life is so short and
right.
he should just be honest.
So when he says, I have only a day, he really feels like that because he just almost died in the story. He's living life day by day, you know. So he's thinking, what if there's no tomorrow? I got to do what I would do if there was no tomorrow, which would be, you know, I want to love you more. I want to look at your face. You know, I want to be with you. I want to be with this person.
I don't want to pretend anymore.
Yeah, I don't want to pretend that I don't want to be with you anymore.
Can't waste it anymore.
Yeah, he can't waste his time anymore.
He's saying, like, let's say it together. Like, tell me you love me too.
Right, you know? Like, tell me you love me back. Now, this is the last track on the album. It's called Funeral Hope. Let's dive. Kanye, is that you? Woo. Church organ, the gospel vibes. Sounds like a choir with the harmony.
Still auto-tune.
I like it. I like the auto-tune. 종종 상상했던 내 장례식에 축하와 환호성 또 박수가 차 가 있는 파티가 됐으면 했네 왜냐면 난 천국에 있기 때문에 오자마자 내 몸집에서 나베 커다란 사자와 침물 먹었네 땅 위에 단어들은 표현 못해 사진을 못 보내는 게 아쉽네 모두 여기서 다시 볼 거라는 확신이 있네
꾸준히 당부해 두길 잘했네 좋은 기억 여기서 다시 볼 거라는 확신이 있네. 내 맘을 다져놓지. Hallelujah. 꿈에 멈추게 입성 하나 들을 위해. Hallelujah. 함께 일어나 춤을 추고
There's your xylophone.
I was gonna say.
There it is.
There's the xylophone.
Woo!
Ah. I love that.
Ooh.
Yo, his use of all these different instruments, like,
yeah,
on this album.
Super
man.
Good. Chanhyuk, so good.
This
man.
Guy is unique. He is creative.
Super creative. The story.
It's different.
So now I'm getting the vibe that maybe in a day, when he was saying there is no tomorrow, that was part of the story. Like, he was actually going to die in a day. Maybe after he was out of the hospital, he was going to die in a certain amount of time. That's why in What Though he's saying, I only have regrets. Like, I'm not ready to die. Castle in my dream literally is in his dreams.
Mm-hmm.
Like, maybe him building a castle with some girl that actually wants him was in his dreams. That feeling of euphoria, that feeling of, you know, getting past it all, was just a dream. You know, he's got a day left, and then he feels like he's got to go talk to her, but he can't because she already told him goodbye. And in this last song, Funeral Hope, it's literally just a funeral. All the faces I know are gathered here. It's amazing that we're all in one place. Sometimes someone I don't know keeps crying. I'm sorry that I don't remember who it was. I'm a funeral, which I often imagine. I hope it's a party with congratulations, cheers, and applause. Why? Because I'm in heaven. And that's why the hook sounds like how it does. As soon as I got here, I ate 3 or 4 lions as big as me. I can't express it with words on the ground. Too bad I can't send you pictures. I'm sure we'll all see each other here again. I'm telling you how I feel. It's a shame that I couldn't do. So he's in heaven looking at his funeral, and he kind of has like this good feeling. Thinks like we'll all see each other here again, like we'll all be in heaven at one point. And he hopes that everyone's just gonna celebrate.
And he feels good that he is in heaven and that there is an afterlife, you know?
Yeah.
There is something good on the other side when you die.
Right.
Like he feels limitless. He just
right.
ate a lion.
He feels free.
You know? I like what he says down here when he says his life is like a buffet. With my whole life on one side.
Like in life, you just try to enjoy everything that you can with all these different possibilities. And then, you know, you leave the restaurant. So I think the whole point of the song and one of the whole points of this album is that we don't have much time to live. So we should do what we want to do right now and live in the moment and live for the day as if there's no tomorrow.
Don't be afraid to do what you want to do.
Yeah, don't be afraid and live life to the fullest. And also express your feelings towards everybody that you have feelings about. You know,
yeah.
If you have appreciation for your family, you know, let them know that you appreciate them. If you are in love with somebody, if you're in love with somebody, let them know that you love them. Don't just let it go.
Don't leave yourself with regrets.
Yeah. If you were to die tomorrow, don't let yourself have any regrets. Think about that.
And there's clearly some people that he hurt by not expressing his feelings.
Right.
You know, they're probably at his funeral thinking,
wondering what he thought.
Yeah, wondering how he felt and why it didn't work out.
Absolutely love that theme of the album, you know, live in the moment. live with no regrets, just live every day like it's your last, and, you know, do what you want to do to the fullest. Like, don't hold back. Don't ever hold back. And we can tell now that this album cover is supposed to be moments before he gets hit by this car in the video. And, you know, the story that pertains to this whole album. The point is, too, is that, you know, one little error in your life could end it, you know? It's as simple as that. You know, just stepping over a little bit this way or whatever he's supposed to portray right here. He got hit by this car, and it changed his life. It changed a whole bunch of people's lives. So he's saying, you could die at any moment. So, live like there's no tomorrow. I'm going to have to say, we opened up this album with a huge bang. I'm going to say Eyewitness Account is my favorite track off this whole album. Because it was tough. I love that vibe. It was something so unexpected. I didn't expect it at all. And it was super good. I love the distorted electric guitars. Really cool. I mean, this whole album is a no skip.
Yeah. I feel like I really like Time Stop.
Right.
What was that song?
That one was good.
That was like... a love song, R&B type of vibe.
This one.
Yes. This is my vibe.
Yes. Yes. Okay. But it's not easy to pick a favorite. I don't think I could list them. Funeral Hope and A Day were probably my least favorite. And Goodbye Stay Well.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I love Chung Ha's vocals and stuff like that. Just wasn't really my vibe. So those three.
I love Panorama.
Weren't like my favorites or anything. But I really liked Missed Call for the depressing vibe. That was so perfect.
The doo-doo-doo, whatever at the
end. Loved, you know, Panorama was so good. So, so, so good.
Funky.
Funky and just on point. Vocals, the instrumental. Time Stops instrumental, so good. So funky. I love the ending. Time. The ad-libs at the end are so cool. If I can't go see you right now, it's just a chill vibe. Like, God, I love the boom bap R&B vibe there. It just brings you back to like the 90s, 2000, early 2000s, like I said. So cool. What the was a cool sad song, I thought.
Mm-hmm.
Great vocals. Castle, My Dream, just a great beachy type of vibe. You know, nice guitars, makes you want to go like this.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as I go to work, Eyewitness Account is getting played. And, I'm playing so many of these. Siren, Panorama. The first five, golden. Pure gold. The only reason I don't like Goodbye Stay Well is just like, it's really lovey and the harmony. And just, I don't know. I like the jazz of it, but I don't know. I wouldn't find myself listening to it that often. Favorites, Eyewitness Account, Panorama, Time Stop, If I Can't Go See You Right Now, Missed Call, those ones are probably my favorites.
I agree. I definitely feel like he's going for a retro vibe because he's got like the light leaks and everything.
Yep. And the different colors, especially the album cover, just feels like going for that vibe. It's got like that psychedelic look of the 80s, you know?
Mm-hmm. I think most of these songs are pretty dancey.
Yeah. Most of these songs are going to put us in a good mood. I know that. Except for Missed Call.
Yeah.
Not. But you guys let me know what's next for AKMU down below in the comments. Also, let me know your favorite tracks off of this album. If you guys have any information about the album or any songs here that maybe we missed or we should have put in here, please let me know down below in the comments. Also, if there's any interpretations that you have that maybe we missed or something you want to add, please let me know down below in the comments. We love reading comments. We love understanding the album and each song even more. So, you know, if there's anything you missed, please let me know. Definitely gonna be checking out a lot of these songs and putting these in my playlist. Chanhyuk, thank you for blessing us with this great music, and congrats on your solo debut and your really well thought out album. Love the theme, and I love the vibe. Perfect. What can I say? I don't think you could have done any better, dude. Like, what else could you do? Really? What else did you want from this guy? I mean, that first song, I will say this, Chanhyuk. If you can deliver more songs like Eyewitness Account, like, that should be your second album. Because you can do that tough sound. Like, you were gliding on that beat, bro. My God. I'm playing that. It's probably going to be one of my most played songs for the rest of this year. I promise you. But thank you so much for critiquing with us. We still have plans to do more AKMU, so let me know the next song for us to react to by AKMU down below in the comments. And we love you guys. You guys stay healthy, stay safe, and stay classy. Charles, a.k.a. Tyler, a.k.a. CriTiC. Gone.
Shy.
Gone.